We're back at Metropole TVKE across all your social media platforms. 2146 as your SMS line. Now let's talk about a leader who is somebody who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. Irrespective of how you define a leader, he or she can prove to be a difference maker between success and failure. This morning, we'll look into what makes one a leader. How can you be a good leader and be impactful? And to help us discuss this, we're joined by Dr. Mary Mugo, an author and a business consultant. Dr. Mary Mugo, good morning.
Morning, Simba. How are you?
We are fine. We are moving forward. Let me just begin by going off script a bit this morning. I would have a proper definition of what a good leader is, Dr. Mugo, but then you would have yours now. So let me ask you, from what perspective could you define a leader?
Thank you very much, Simba, for having you. Always my pleasure. Now, a leader is someone who influences others. Yeah? And the influence is through inspiration, not through coercion, not through force. You know? If you're a leader and you're influencing people by punishing them, threatening them, you're not a leader. So leaders influence people through inspiration. Leaders have a conviction. Leaders have a passion, and leaders have a purpose. So you are a leader if you can influence others through inspiration. And Sip, allow me to say that you can be holding a position, but you're not a leader. You can even be a CEO of a company and you're not a leader. Eh? But if you hold a position, it is expected you demonstrate leadership. So sometimes people confuse leaders, managers, positions. But actually, you don't have to hold any position to be a leader. Because as long as you can influence people through inspiration, then you truly are a leader, Simba.
Yes. Let me ask you this as well, Dr. Mugo, even as we talk about just by the virtue that you have probably a business position somewhere in some big company, it doesn't make you a leader. Let me ask you this. How do you motivate? Because you're saying it's not through coercion, it's through showing by example. Does it mean that you have to really be good at what you do so that others can emulate? Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah, you see, a leader must act in a way that people want to follow you. You see,
yes.
People use coercion because people don't want to follow you. Simba, if you remember, I don't know whether you are born town or a villager like me.
I'm a villager. I'm a villager. I call myself a hometown boy.
If you are a villager, then you know there were some games we used to play when in the village.
Yes.
And people would say, so and so is going to be the father, so and so is going to be the mother.
Yes.
And sometimes the children would say, no, we don't want this one to become. Now, that tells you there's something they were seeing in you that they want to follow you. So if you are a leader and you hold a position, you must do things. In fact, you must have qualities that people want to emulate. You must have qualities that people want to be associated with. For example, you can't be a leader and you have no integrity. You don't keep your word. You know, when you say something, you know, you don't keep it. So you've got to motivate people by what you do, what you say, how you act. That is how leaders influence others. Because you see, there's nothing like you say what you do what I say, not what I do. Leaders, you do what we do.
Fantastic. Yeah. Yes, Dr. Mugo, let me also point you out to an area.
There are various qualities that each and every leader should have. There are very many, but one of them is integrity. And
yes.
Integrity is honoring your word. Yeah? What you say, what is expected of you, what are those things that people expect you to do. So a leader must have integrity. You must be complete.
All right. Let's therefore look at another area
You see, you can't be a leader and you have no character.
Yes.
You must have the courage to do things and to even give bad news. You see, many times leaders don't want to give bad news, but a good leader must actually have the courage to say that basically things are like this. A good leader, of course, must be very competent. You see, many people want positions, but they are very incompetent. If you're incompetent, you will start coercing people, punishing people, daring people off. A leader must be seen to be competent. They must be able to do what they are supposed to do. And a leader, simple, must be able to communicate, you know? A leader who does not communicate travels alone, because how will I know what I'm supposed to do if you can't communicate? I know there are some people who hold positions simple, they don't want to tell you anything. They want to hold the information to feel powerful, you know? You don't feel powerful because you are holding information. A leader must also have charisma, yeah? They must generate that trust, yeah? Actually, Simba, the major problem with leaders today is because there's no trust. People don't trust them. They don't generate that trust. They don't inspire trust. Someone tells you we'll be paying you on 20th, 30th comes. They are not even telling you they are not paying you. Yeah. You need to generate trust. A leader should also be curious. In other words, they need to know what is happening everywhere. You see, you must be expansive. You must be somebody who wants to see the entire organization. You don't see myopically. You see, for example, I'm a leader, I'm a business in terms of profession. If I go and I'm leading in an institution, I can't only see my side of my training. I must be curious to know what is happening. A leader must be very creative, Simba. Like, we are in a COVID era, you know? Some leaders are sad and they are like, eat a bit and you need to be creative, do things different, like you are doing Simba. We are speaking, but we are not together, you know? That is being creative. And a leader must have conviction, Simba. How, you must know that, you must have that conviction that this thing's going to happen. By the way, your followers can tell when you don't believe in something, yeah? So if you're a leader, you must believe, if you're a good leader, you must believe in what you're saying. And Simba, a leader must be able to weather crisis, you know? Like now we are in a crisis. This is the time we know who a leader is. And above all things, Simba, a leader must have common sense. You see, most leaders have no common sense. You know, common sense basically means you can listen and you do the right thing, you know? Managers, Simba, do things right. Leaders do the right thing because they use common sense. Some managers don't use common sense at all, because we say common sense is not common. So if you want to motivate people, you need to cultivate those kind of qualities and many others that people want to emulate. People trust you as their leader. People want to follow you, you know? Simba, if you are a leader and nobody wants to follow you, you need to think twice. Or you tell people to do something, they are like, why is this guy telling us to do this and he comes at 11? So those are a few qualities that will tell you you're really inspiring people, you are a good leader. And above all things, integrity is the most important, above all things.
Yes.
Leader must keep their word. And your word is not what is written. Your word is even what you speak, is what is expected of you. All these things. So don't, if you're a leader, don't start telling your staff, I did not promise you in writing, I was joking. There's no joking in leadership. I hope Simba have answered your question.
Yes, you have, Dr. Mugo. Okay, let's talk about this other area as well, on a broader perspective, and in your own, I would say, understanding. Can you get trained into being a leader? And I want you to touch on this aspect of emotional intelligence as well.
Yeah, a leader must have emotional intelligence. Emotional intelligence is defined in a different way. You must be able to understand your own emotions and the emotions of others. You see, as a leader, for lack of a better word, you can't be someone who is, we can see how visibly angry you are, no? Even when Simba has done so bad, you must keep your emotions, you must be self-aware. If you know that you're hot-tempered, because you can be a leader if you're hot-tempered, then you must be aware that you are a hot-tempered person, and therefore you manage your hot-tempered, you know? So a leader must have emotional intelligence. Why is that important? Because remember, the way you act is important as a leader. You cannot, you know, there are some people, you do something wrong in the office, they are shouting at you, they are yelling, they are your CEO. I didn't imagine a CEO yelling in the office, my friend. you know, you've got to control your own emotions, and more so, you've got to also read other people's emotions. That's part of emotional intelligence. Are you able to see the emotions of your own staff? And that is important for a leader, Simba, because a leader should be able to tell even when their members of staff have a problem. I believe a good leader should be able to tell that this particular member of staff has a problem. And you can't do that unless you're able to read other people's emotions. You can imagine you come from home, there are issues, because there will always be issues in life. You feel like you want to cry, although your men don't cry. And the leader is yelling at you, you're telling you, you look so bad, what is wrong with you? They're supposed to read the emotions and do that. So leaders must actually exercise emotional intelligence, because if you don't, we will be able to know the weakest link of your leadership. Because you can imagine if you're abusing people everywhere. I've even heard leaders and politicians abusing each other very badly. And those are not leaders, they just hold positions. A leader must be able to, you know, speak right, must be able to say right. Even when things are thick, the way you say things, actually, in communication, the way you say something is even more important than what you say. And the way you say something is dependent on the emotional aspect of it. However, the most important thing is, as you bring that emotional intelligence, your emotions should inspire people. So a good leader also uses emotions to speak, because people will buy into your vision if you are emotional. And that is why there are some leaders in this nation, when they speak, people go and demonstrate, because they are using emotions to speak. So you use it in different ways to the advantage of the organization.
Yes. All right. Yeah. Let's get into another area, therefore. I mean, you are a leader in a business environment. How do you know that it's not working? Because it's true, you might not get the feedback that you need directly, but how do you know that my leadership skills here, they are not working at all?
It's very easy. Simba, you can easily know that your leadership is not working, number one, if people don't want to tell you anything. You know, I keep saying, remember I've said a good leader is curious, a good leader knows what is happening around.
Yes.
If you realize that people really come to your office to tell you anything. By the way, a leader should also be able to have some gossip. Gossip is part of management. Yeah. If you realize that people are withholding information, they don't want to speak to you, there could be a problem. If you realize that the turnover in the organization, especially if you are the CEO or a department for that matter, the turnover is too high, the absenteeism is too high, or you realize that people are no longer doing their best, people have no organizational commitment, they don't go beyond their call of duty, you tell them, hey, Siva, you will need to come and, you know, do something for Tabe, who is not in today, and Siva is like, hey, I had other plans, I'm not, there's something wrong. Okay, if you realize that the members of staff look a bit withdrawn, demotivated, they are not willing to do much, then you know your leadership is not working. And by the way, a good leader also appreciates criticism.
Yes.
So if you also realize that every time the members of staff tell you something you don't like and you're getting out of control, there's a problem. So there are various ways you can actually know that your leadership is not working. And of course, if the productivity is low, you know, people are all of a sudden, someone who used to do so well is not there. And also your medical is going up because people are getting headaches, stress, you know. Even the leader themselves gets stressed up. You can easily tell, actually, when your leadership is not working, Simba.
All right. Now, let's talk about that area, therefore. I mean, yes, how do you, therefore, start changing your style? As a leader, when you realize, things are not working, where do you begin a form in that organization or that leadership position?
See, but you know, maybe that we can talk about that another day, but also it's good to also understand
yes.
that the leadership style is dependent on the followers.
Okay.
And there are different types of followers. So actually the first thing you should do as a leader is understand the type of followers that you have.
Yes.
You have what we call the yes fellas, the guys who, whatever you tell them, they do even if it is wrong. You know, we have what we call the sheep followers.
Yes.
The sheep followers are those nice people. I think that's why the book says the sheep will go to heaven. They're just nice. They don't know. They are passive. They just do what they must do. Then there are those guys who are called alienated followers.
Yes.
Alienated followers are those kind of followers who criticize you and never give you any solution. You tell them anything, they tell you, ah, see, my channel, that's what we do. Why are you not clear? Then there are followers who, you know, who are survivors. They are called survivors. They are just there because they need something. But then they are good followers. Good followers those who criticize you and give you solutions. And yes. By then, most leaders don't like them. They don't like those good followers who criticize you and tell you. So as a leader, the first thing you need to do, you need to find out what kind of people am I leading. Because Simba, your leadership style should not be the same every day. It will depend on the people you're leading. If you're leading people who are yes people, then you must have a style where you give all the instructions at all the time. But if you're leading, for example, a good follower, someone who is independent, someone who is critical but solves problems, then you don't supervise them.
Yes.
So you change your style depending on the kind of people that you're leading. And also you change your style depending on the situation you're in. If you're in a crisis, you cannot start consulting. You see, if you're in crisis, the style must change. So there are different leadership styles, and every leadership style will be useful depending on the situation you are in and depending on the type of people you are leading. And see, let me give you an example. We had a very good president, President Kibaki, you know, and he did very well. And people, before, he did very well, but people used to say, oh, you know, he's handsome. Because Kenyans think you must push them, you must supervise them. So it depends on where you are. But as a leader, understand that your people are different. You cannot lead the same way.
Yes.
Your people are motivated by different things. For example, personally, I'm motivated when I do something. So if you supervise me, I'm not able to work. I go to the office, I know what I'm supposed to do, I will do it. If you supervise me, I'll do nothing. But the others, if you don't supervise them, they'll never do anything. So as a leader, change your style depending on various variables.
Pretty much, Dr. Mary Mugo, author and consultant. We normally enjoy talking to you this morning. Thank you very time for making time to begin this Monday with us.
Yeah, thank you, Simba, for having me. I think you need to talk to your CEO so that we can have this show every Monday. Then, we will have good times.
Pretty much. On that, we take a short break on Business AM. Once we come back, our economic review.